what's the Tea Party all about? She wanted me to explain it. I said, it's not my job to explain it or speak for them. They're sick of being spoken for by politicians. I'm going there to listen. And I think that credit is due to the elected officials that are here to listen. They're not here to talk to you or force feed you like you're so used to having done. They're here to listen. And I saw our deputy minority leader from the Rockland County Legislature walk in, Ed Dead. So everybody give him a round of applause. Normally, as so many of you have been to probably a lot of meetings, at the beginning of a meeting, you introduce the dignitaries, and I don't have a list of dignitaries. And Mike Dolan, the chairman of the Rand Paul Republican Committee, he's here. Ed Day, deputy minority leader. But if there are any other elected officials here that had the guts to show up and be heard and listen to what the people want, send your name up here. I mean, you deserve to be at least introduced. Okay, next. Our next speaker is Thomas Borelli. Dr. Thomas Borelli is a senior fellow with the National Center for Public Policy Research, Washington, D.C. Public Policy Group. Tom also serves as the director of National Center's Free Enterprise Project. In that role, he defends the free enterprise system by challenging government actions such as regulating and taxation that stifle economic growth. He is a fierce critic of CEOs who seek short-term profit by designing their business strategies to align with the social and political goals of government and progressive activists. Ladies and gentlemen, Tom Borelli. Good afternoon, patrons.
Good afternoon.
You're here today because you feel the country is not going in the right direction. Frankly, we the people have had enough. Yeah. We've had enough of record budget deficits, of Wall Street and auto company bailouts, of stimulus money going to support bloated state budgets, of elected officials who ram major policy initiatives such as health care reform and cap and trade down our throats. Yeah. We, the people, have had enough. We, the people, are also had enough of corporate CEOs who are undermining our country. Financial CEOs who make bad bets on housing and mortgages and then need your money to bail them out. We've had enough. The auto CEOs who allow labor unions and environmentalists to run their companies into the ground and then you bail them out. And now, as we're here today, we have CEOs who are working with progressive politicians to advance government-run health care. We also have CEOs who are working with government to run our energy policy through cap and trade. We've had enough. Indeed, CEOs can threaten our liberty as much as any progressive politician. Let me repeat that. A CEO can loot us of our liberty more than many politicians. It's time that we, the people, hold them accountable, too. Corporations are playing a major role in advancing President Obama's health care plan and cap and trade. These policies would significantly expand the role of government over our lives and loot us of our liberty. First, let's talk about health care. Corporate America was the first to play in President Obama's new White House game show, Let's Make a Deal. Come on down, Pfizer! President Obama worked a deal to limit the cost of the health care plan to the drug industry in exchange for their support. In return, the drug companies spent $100 million advertising Obama's plan. Nice, isn't it? To summarize, Obama got $100 million free campaign money to promote his plan, and the drug industry bought protection. And we, the people, are getting ripped off. It's time for all of us to hold these CEOs accountable. We can't rely on the boards of directors. We know that for sure. It's up to us. It's up to patriots. Corporate interests are also driving the economy-killing energy legislation called cap and trade. Companies such as General Electric, Caterpillar, DuPont, Johnson & Johnson, and many others have joined with progressive politicians and environmental groups to push for a cap and trade law. My God, what are they thinking? The lobbying effort enjoyed great success. Corporations were responsible for passing the so-called Waxman-Markey bill, the cap and trade bill that passed the House of Representatives last May. Congressman Ed Markey, a progressive from Massachusetts, who co-sponsored the bill, touted the role of the corporations. Their support is indispensable. It's time we the people let CEOs know there will be a price to pay for when they promote laws that will loot us of our liberty. Every day we can vote with our wallets and avoid buying the products from these companies that are undermining our values. It makes no sense for a liberty-minded person to buy products from companies who are then going to use that money against us. Here are a few examples. My favorite, General Electric. General Electric, you might have seen me criticize him once or twice. General Electric CEO Jeff Immelt is on President Obama's economic advisory panel, all Rashad. And GE is lobbying very hard for cap and trade. I'll get to there. Just last week, ML met with Treasury Secretary Tim Geithner, who I can't pay my taxes, and White House climate czar Carol Browner to try to salvage cap and trade. You see, ML has made a huge bet on making money on global warming fears, and this is how he does it. In the Waxman-Markey bill, there is a requirement that we have to buy our electricity from renewable energy sources. Anybody hear wind turbines? Yeah. So essentially, he's using the law to mandate the purchase of his products. GE also ends NBC Universal, the media empire, NBC, CNBC, and one of my favorites, MSNBC. These networks are frequently promoting Obama's agenda, including the president's green agenda. Remember NBC Green Week? So here's what we can do, patriots. Vote with your wallet. Don't let your hard-earned dollars go to GE so the company can use your money to lobby against your interests. Don't buy GE microwaves, refrigerators, washing machines, ranges, light bulbs. And don't use those private label credit cards, Home Depot, Walmart, and et cetera, because GE is behind those. For those of us who buy gasoline, avoid BP and Shell. They're part of this lobbying coalition for cap and trade. Fill up at another gas station. Johnson & Johnson. Johnson & Johnson is not only lobbying for cap and trade, they are also lobbying for health care. Johnson & Johnson tried to use their power as a member of the Chamber of Commerce to silence the Chamber of Commerce's criticism of cap and trade. So they're trying to muscle their own trade association. You know, thinking all this kind of gives me a headache. But when I get one, no Tylenol for me. Speeches, you know, I may get a few cuts and bruises, no band-aids. Nike and Starbucks are also on the global warming bandwagon. They're members of a pro-climate change lobbying group called Business for Innovative Climate and Energy Policy. What are they thinking? Here's an idea. When you look down, look at your sneakers, make sure you're not wearing Nikes. And when you go to the coffee store, let's just do it and run by Starbucks. In conclusion, CEOs can be a risk to limited government and liberty. Please join me in fighting big business that are undermining our values and our free market system. Visit our table on the side of the room and sign up. We're going to be doing a campaign this spring. I'll be going to many shareholder meetings where I'll stand up for your rights and take the CEOs on. It's time to be the people. Now we're moving.